Hello everyone, Friday evening, and this is Marisha from the Wedding School. All set and very excited to be chatting with all of you. Big hello to all my friends. And yes, I'm hoping that you've had a great week. A week that has been productively spent, a week where you have invested a lot of time in working towards your goal, living every moment to the fullest. I have done some crazy things this weekend, but I'm going to not be discussing on that this week. But I do hope that you have also invested your time in, you know, trying to improve your skills, no matter what you're doing in life. And more importantly, no matter at which level you are in your life. Jatin is saying hello. Hi, Jatin. Hope you're doing good. So, yes, I truly believe that every human being can truly work on themselves every passing day. There is something new to learn. There is something new to explore. There is knowledge that can never go waste. In fact, in this morning's newspaper, I'm still a newspaper person, you know, call me old fashioned, but I just love that experience of reading a paper in the morning. So in today's paper, I read that, you know, one of the most talented artists that we have in our country, Shalmali, has actually gone, to the US of A to pursue and to do a course, which is, I think, running into 5 weeks. And that's a lot of time for an artist who is truly busy over here, an artist who does playback, does fantastic live events, an artist who is also a judge on some reality show, taking time out and actually learning more in music. She's mentioned that she's actually given auditions, and you know, that's part of the learning that she's going through, and I think that is fantastic. So I'd really urge everyone to, you know, spend some time every week, if not on a daily basis, and dedicate it to improving your skills and, you know, pursuing a hobby or getting to know a little more about something that is of interest to you. Of course, my interest definitely lies in weddings, and there is something creatively, that I keep exploring every week. This week, of course, I think I have really improved on my editing skills, trying to cut out some videos of the work that we've done in the last year. And oh boy, I think my experience of having done this, I think 2 years back to now, has drastically changed. My way of looking at things has, you know, really changed. I got Dharini with me. Hello, 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 Dharini. And congratulations to you. I think you're doing so well. I just cannot even begin to tell you, Dharini, how proud you make me. Not just because you're a good Jew. I mean, that, of course, is one of the aspects. But more so to see how, you know, a person who is so grounded and is so low profile can simply be fantastic at her job and literally become a favorite with everyone. And Dharini, you are a favorite. And I'm not just saying this because of the close relation that I share with you now, but purely by the kind of response that I get from other wedding planners, from my clients. I think you're doing fantastic, fantastic. And now with your new track and playback singing coming your way, oh my God, fingers crossed, it's just going to get bigger. Okay, so today my topic is event management versus wedding management. So there are two ways in which I could approach this topic. One is to make it completely controversial, okay, sensationalize, and probably somewhere lose track, because it is a topic that can actually garner a lot of responses. And if I have to discuss this topic in terms of which is a more challenging industry to be in, you know, there's enough and more that can be spoken for and against both these industries. However, I am very focused, and today my focus is purely in terms of how are these two different, you know, from each other. How is event management different from wedding management? So I'm going to be dealing with this through a couple of points. Firstly, discussing the approach, you know, going that extra mile. Secondly, on the basis of the knowledge and the know-how which is required, I think an important point to also touch upon would be, you know, the power of newness and the demand of newness which is required in corporate events versus weddings. Another topic, you know, that I would like to sort of dwell into is the career prospects that you have, the level of competition that there is, and of course, the kind of professional training that you require if you wish to pursue corporate events, you know, as a stream of work versus weddings. Ritharaj sir is here. Hello, hello, sir. Good job that you're doing. Thank you so much, sir. And I have to tell you this, I wanted to actually pick the phone on you and let you know. I thought that, you know, what you had posted a couple of days back was a fantastic idea. With regards to you, you know, conducting walk-in sessions wherever you are doing the setup, because you do have too many people asking you too many questions, and you know, an opportunity to be live in a venue space and thereby learn, you know, through you, I think that's a fantastic idea. Please do go ahead and you know, keep us posted. I would love to be there as well. In fact, Ritharaj sir, I had touched upon the several points that you had shared with me in terms of, you know, what are the things that people need to take care of, whether it's to do with security or planning or negotiations with vendors. So in my last chat, I did manage to cover a lot of that. Bhavik is here as well. Bhavik says, wow, you're really amazing. Thank you so much, Bhavik. I don't know what to say when I get a compliment, but thank you. And I was just complimenting Dharani and Bhavik. Kudos to you. I'm not trying to say you're doing a favor, but I think support from a husband means the world to a woman. So genuinely, in those aspects, kudos to you. You have not just gained a lot of professional success in whatever you are doing. You have not just made a star out of a fantastic singer, which is Rahul. I think he truly values your support and contribution. But you've also made an amazing artist and an artist who's become a favorite in terms of your wife. So kudos to you, and I hope to meet you soon. All right, so talking about event management versus wedding management, I think firstly what we need to understand, and this is also a shout out to a lot of those who are very, very, very eager to join the industry, you know, this chat is definitely going to help you make that decision in terms of where, in which stream of work, you know, would you like to sort of pursue your life towards. It's imperative for you to firstly understand that there was a time when it was just event management, okay? And I'm talking about maybe 15 or 18 years back, where it was simply about event management. And within events, there was a parsing sort of session that institutes would take, which would touch upon topics like sports management and weddings, special projects, etc. But I think over the last few years, people have realized more and more and things have changed. Today, weddings is taken as a parallel stream of work. It is no more treated as part of an event management course. Today, you have, you know, a lot of institutes, not as many, there are still a handful, the wedding school being one of them, where the focus is largely to do with understanding and learning the in-depth know-how of how to deal and manage and plan weddings. One of the major differences comes from the fact that the base is very different. While event management is definitely more specific, there is also a professional touch, you know, to your approach towards dealing with a multinational, towards dealing with, say, a product launch or a conference. It's professional. You are given a job, you do it. Whereas in weddings, it's a mountain of emotions. It is personal money of the client that you're dealing with, unlike in corporate events where your focus is largely to do with the marketing budget, which is then a part of which is given to you to sort of, you know, put an event together. So with emotions and personal money becoming a big factor of weddings, the entire approach definitely changes. You have to learn to manage people as much as knowledge is required. You cannot upset people. You cannot let your temperament or your bad day affect the emotions that are riding so high. There are highs and lows. And these highs and lows, guys, are not subjected to just 3 days. It is at least 9 to 12 months of relationship building. You cannot expect your client to have a good day every day and a professional tone. Clients will treat you like their family. So they love you as much and they criticize you as much. They are, you know, frank enough to tell you when things are going a little tough in their personal relationships, and I mean it. You know, you become a confidant and it's not easy to hold on to that role and yet maneuver things around to ensure that you are doing your professional job right. So that becomes for me one very strong defining, you know, factor that differentiates the two of them. The other major difference that I find is how much do you go, you know, the all-out approach which is required. Ritharatso is saying that, you know, it's going good. Sir, I hope you're still here and I would love your inputs while I speak on this topic. So please stay here with us. Event management is a line of work where, you know, there is little scope to do anything as an add-on. You primarily have to go by a brief. You know, your enhancement contribution is far more restricted unless you are given a specific brief of going all out. Unlike weddings, in which every single function, every single moment creation needs to have a value addition, you have to go that extra mile, whether it's in terms of sending an invitation, whether it's in terms of inviting a guest over a call, whether it's in terms of how do you take travel details. So there is that extra that is required at all levels. And that for me becomes the next very important differentiating factor about how much of an extra mile, and it's not just a mile, it can go on and on as far as weddings are concerned. I hope I am able to communicate through today's chat that I am not at all trying to make it seem like corporate events is an easier job as compared to weddings. Both of them have their own set of challenges. However, it is being sort of misunderstood by a lot of the youngsters, you know, the youth, the college going kids, the young professionals who are just kind of making a shift from a forced profession into a profession of their choice, that if I learn event management, then I will automatically be able to manage myself in a wedding company. And that is not the case. The reason I'm even discussing this is to help you understand that there are very different streams of work. Your capabilities, your skill set needs to be completely different. And you've got to really work towards enhancing that. We come to the next point, which is on knowledge, you know, the know-how. In corporate events, yes, you do study a company, you understand their background, you understand the kind of events that they would have done. And therefore, that sort of sets a benchmark of how you take their particular event forward. However, when it comes to weddings, I think the knowledge that you require is a little different. Technically, yes, you need to be sound, but you can also achieve a lot by having partnered with the right kind of vendors, where your knowledge needs to be more personal and intimate in terms of their background, their standard of living, the kind of culture, you know, there are people from different religions getting married to each other. You've got to be sensitive towards that. There are elders in the family who get very offended when, younger players just come in and professionally try to do things, and they think we're taking away, from the joy of putting things together. So while you're being called in because you're knowledgeable, you have a professional approach towards doing something, you need to have enough of knowledge about that particular family's background and their culture as well. And the challenging part is every client is different from the other. You can never generalize that if it is a Marwari, then all the Marwari families will be behaving in this way. That is unfortunately not the way it works. As far as corporates are concerned, universally, globally, you will see that there is a pattern, a format which you are expected to follow. Hence, getting yourself updated on a client's requirement is a less time-consuming job as compared to, a wedding client. How can I put this? The next point is a little tricky, and I am going to talk about it, but it's a constant argument that I have with a lot of my friends from the event industry, from the corporate space, which is newness. I have Sanket joining me here. Sanket has written, "Hello ma'am, good work." Thank you, Sanket. I am interested, kya diploma educational program Marathi and Hindi medium mein hai? Because mera English itna acha nahi hai. As you can see, mera Hindi itna acha nahi hai. And main is industry mein career karna chahta hoon. But financial condition नहीं है. Any other options? Part-time internship and learn your diploma course. Sanket, I will ensure that my team gets in touch with you and they will be pinging you shortly on Messenger. Language barrier के बारे में कहूँ, so don't you worry. क्योंकि जितना भी मैं Facebook में अंग्रेजी में बात कर लूँ, the fact of life is जब हम शादियों का काम करते हैं, आमतौर पे बहुत सारे ऐसे सिचुएशंस और फैमिली के साथ हम डील करते हैं जहाँ पे हिंदी का उपयोग बहुत ज़्यादा रहता है. जब हम वेंडर्स से बात करते हैं तभी भी इस भाषा का उपयोग रहता है. अगर आप महाराष्ट्र से हैं तो डेफिनेटली नोइंग मराठी विल बिकम लाइक एन अपर एज इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ विच सिटी ऑफ महाराष्ट्र यू बिलोंग टू. सो इतना कहूंगी दैट आज जिस तरह दुनिया आगे बढ़ रही है, इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज में बातचीत कर पाना, बेसिक कम्युनिकेशन ईमेल पे एक्सचेंज कर पाना, ये बहुत बहुत ज़्यादा आवश्यक है. तो इसे आप बिल्कुल इग्नोर ना करें, और भले ही आप नॉलेज जो है उसका एप्लीकेशन हिंदी में कर पाए, लेकिन कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स जो है वो अगर थोड़ा बहुत आप इंग्लिश जानते हैं और उसको आप ब्रश अप करेंगे तो आपको डेफिनेटली ये एक एड ऑन बेनिफिट और एडवांटेज रहेगा. बाकी जैसे ऋतुराज सर कह रहे हैं, इवेंट्स हैज़ नो लैंग्वेज बैरियर. सो वेल सेड, एंड दैट इज ट्रू. हाउएवर यूनिवर्सली एंड ग्लोबली एंड गोइंग बाय व्हाट होल्ड्स इन द फ्यूचर, डेफिनेटली अ बेसिक नॉलेज ऑफ क्लीन इंग्लिश. आप बड़े शब्द का इस्तेमाल ना कर पाए, सो वॉट, दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. लेकिन कुछ हद तक अगर इंग्लिश आप जानते हैं, प्रोफेशनल लैंग्वेज थोड़ा आप अपना फाइन ट्यून कर ले तो बहुत बहुत अच्छा रहेगा. विथ रिगार्ड्स टू आर कोर्स एंड येस, वी कैन डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू विथ एन इंटर्नशिप, जो कि आप एक ऐसी कंपनी में कर सकते हैं जिसका वातावरण आपको थोड़ा सूट करेगा, जहाँ पे इतने हाईफाई लोग नहीं होंगे, लेकिन शादियाँ जो है बढ़िया करेंगे वो. सो माय टीम विल गेट इन टच विथ यू. एंड यस ऋतुराज सर, दैट इज ट्रू. इन फैक्ट लुक एट द वे आई कीप सीइंग दैट इन ICWF एज वेल, एंड आई एम श्योर यू एक्सपीरियंस इट एवरी सिंगल डे इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाउ विथ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस एंड कल्चर्स एज वेल वी आर ऑल डूइंग फिनोमिनल वर्क. And a person who may have come from very humble beginnings is professionally doing very well as a planner or as a decorator because of the passion. I think passion is something that is, something you cannot replace at all. Nitin is here with us. Hello, 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 Nitin. Friends, I think Nitin would be somebody who can really add to what I'm discussing in terms of corporate events. Of course, we were having a chat, I think just 2 days back. Nitin, you did a fantastic job with the Google setup that you all did. Fantastic, fantastic. I just loved, you know, what you have put up. We were just discussing about, you know, corporate events versus weddings. And Nitin happened to, you know, haste hue mazak mein just happened to say, you know, the systems are not as much. But you will be surprised, as I had told you, Nitin, that things have got far more professional. They have got far more systematic. At least Bombay ki shaadiyon mein, we have to follow a lot of paperwork. I have seen that with most planners. Unlike Delhi, where my friends from Delhi keep saying that hum client ko bata dete aur wahi kaafi hai. Bombay ka market thoda alag hai, Gujarat ka market thoda alag hai, jahan pe hume batana padta hai, lekin usse zyada zaruri hai hume dikhana padta hai. We've got to have everything in black and white. The South industry also works on those very similar lines. So I think it's good, you know, there is no reason for me to complain, because I really believe that as a wedding planner, as somebody who is managing a wedding, if you don't have systems in place, then you must not use the term planner for yourself, because that is the least required from, you know, a professional. So no complaints there. But yes, Nitin, hamara kaam bhi bahut challenging hota hai. Unlike what you may have heard at the recently concluded event in Delhi, where it just seemed like weddings is fun. No, let's not categorize it and make it frivolous. It's there. Natasha is joining us. Hi, Natasha. Good to hear from you. Vendor procurement and management, which is of utmost importance in the event space, needs you to be well-versed in Hindi. So true. Sanket, yahan pe Natasha wahi baat kar rahi hai jo maine aapse kaha ki वेंडर्स से जब हम बातचीत करते हैं और जब छोटे शहरों में हम इवेंट्स करते हैं, चाहे वो शादियां हो या कॉर्पोरेट इवेंट्स हो, वहाँ पे ज़्यादातर हिंदी का उपयोग होता है. ऑफ कोर्स आप डाउन साउथ जाओगे तो लोकल असिस्टेंस रहना भी बहुत ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि हिंदी के अलावा भी बाकी भाषाओं की जानकारी होनी बहुत ज़रूरी है. सेम गोज विद द सिटी लाइक कोलकाता. So yes, Natasha, absolutely true and truly well put. But I still will want to insist that every person today, especially from small towns, needs to get their knowledge on English, their skills of speaking English a little more stronger than what it is. Nitin is adding, but bigger the wedding, more the mess. Paperwork is okay, but what about safety and pollution? Very sensitive point that you're touching, Nitin. I have to confess this. On a very serious note, unlike corporate events, where multinational companies have their set of rules which need to be followed, irrespective of which city and which country you're working in. And this, guys, I'm talking from my experience of having anchored, you know, live shows, been a master of ceremonies for nearly 2 decades now, where there are several companies, I can instantly think of Castrol, that would just not allow us to start an event without the first announcement, even before you say a good evening, being about, you know, the exit policy of the hotel, and in case of an emergency, how do you step out, where do you step out. So there is a lot of insistence on that. Yes, Nitin, I have to confess, unfortunately, that is not of great priority as far as a lot of wedding clients are concerned. I am not just referring to the top, most expensive 10 weddings that may have taken place in a year. I am referring to the hundreds, which are very large scale weddings of educated families. But if that means an additional cost, which sometimes it does, I have seen clients in my own personal capacity and otherwise, when I've discussed and met so many hotels and, you know, especially your open venues, the farmhouses and your, you know, the open venues, where there have been a lot of people who've been negligent. And This for me, Nitin, is very disappointing, but I would genuinely hope that planners can educate themselves and become more responsible. दो पैसे क्लाइंट के बचा के तुम यू नो हजारों की जिंदगी दाव पे लगा रहे हो. अगर ये छोटी सी बात अगर लोगों की समझ में आए, आई थिंक इट वुड रियली हेल्प अस यू नो इन टर्म्स ऑफ बीइंग मोर रिस्पॉन्सिबल इन आवर वर्क. There are venues who have their precautions to be followed. Like we have the NSCI Dome here, and you know you have the Pragati Maidan there, and several other venues across India. However, personal capacity में जो events कर लेते हैं, और mediocre planners के साथ जो काम कर लेते हैं, average decorators जब काम में लग जाते हैं, तो वो दो पैसे बचाने में पता नहीं क्या हो जाता है, but लोग करते हैं, which is something that yes needs to be rectified. But yes, there is no mess, Nitin. Trust me. I'm going to invite you to Hyderabad and Bombay and Bangalore, where we have very systematic work, where every single second is mentioned on paper and is followed to the T. I think the only control जिस पे हमारा नहीं होता है वो है बारात. क्योंकि वो जो लड़के वाले जब डांस करना शुरू कर देते हैं तब उफ क्या कहे, यू नो यू डोंट यू कैन नॉट स्पॉइल इट, यू कैन नॉट टेल देम इट्स क्लॉक, यू नो यू कैन नॉट स्टॉप देम फ्रॉम देयर मोमेंट ऑफ फन, बट इट इज सिस्टमैटिक. Natasha, thank you so much for joining us, and I really appreciate your contribution, and I'm sure everyone listening in is also loving you interacting and commenting. I'm going to touch upon the next point, which is a major difference for me, is in terms of the newness, which is got to do with the fact of, you know, how do you bring a couple into a venue. There are a handful of corporate events where the CEO or the managing director is going to insist on walking up on stage, you know, with a lot of fanfare. Usually they're criticized for going over the top. Unlike weddings, jahan par every new film brings a new idea. या तो प्लानर को, या तो ब्राइड जो है उसी को, या तो ब्राइड की बहन, या ब्राइड के फादर, या ग्रूम की बहन. सो एवरी वन इज इंटरेस्टेड इन नोइंग नया क्या है. टीवी सीरियल्स को देख के लोग यू नो प्रभावित हो जाते हैं. अवार्ड नाइट्स जो होती है, आईफा, फिल्म फेयर, ऑस्कर्स तक. So I have a lot of, you know, we see a lot of people who actually write into us, our clients, you know, switch on this channel and watch this. This is the kind of prop that, you know, I'm looking at. It's crazy. Shreyas is here with us. Shreyas Puranik is saying, Marisha, okay, Shreyas, that is a lot of love coming from you. Thank you so much for that loud shout out. So I wish I could sing and say hello to you. Meri awaaz itni surili nahi hai, but Shreyas, very proud of you. And congratulations to you. And guys, you have to go and check out his new song in the movie that has just released. Shreyas, I'm forgetting the name of the film. I think it has got Javed Jafri's son in it. So that's how I'm trying to recollect the name. If you can please share it over here, I would love to speak about it. Natasha is writing in, we should connect and see how TWS and we can work together. Let's plan and catch up soon. Keep up the good work. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Natasha. And yes, the wedding school will be absolutely honored to have you as part of it. And I think every single person who can, you know, sort of join hands and help in contributing is just going to further work for the benefit of the youngsters who are so keen to join the wedding industry. Last year when we started the wedding school, the number of students that had just inquired versus the number of students who are now with us, it's crazy. The number of inquiries that we churn every day just speaks about how much more curious people are getting, how much more they're realizing that educating yourself in a specialized field is so much more important than just getting generic knowledge. So thank you so much, everyone, for the wonderful, wonderful response that we are getting. I have just got the name of your movie, Shreyas. It is Malaal. Guys, if you haven't watched it, please watch it. But more importantly, please do listen to the wonderful track which Shreyas Puranik has sung. Fantastic voice. And Shreyas, I'm dying to work with you. And you know that. I've been trying very hard. Lekin wo hote hai na, the stars need to connect. And I'm sure that's going to happen very, very soon. I think I'm going to quickly touch upon my last two points, which is got to do in terms of the career prospects. While in event management in the corporate stream of work, it's a clutter. It's a massive clutter, and you cannot blame it because it has been about 30-40 years of lots of companies that have come into existence, a lot of mini companies that have broken out of, you know, large enterprises and started their own, and therefore it's multifold. There is a requirement for corporate event companies in the smallest of cities, and let's face it, the cost of starting a company is much lesser as compared to the stream of manufacturing, because event management, wedding management, we're largely service oriented industries. So with that kind of lesser startup investment required, chances of more players coming in is far greater. However, in the field of weddings, I will say, yes, there's competition. The competition which has been getting very fierce, competition which has led to, you know, undercutting, which exists in most industries, competition that has can affect the short-term sort of, you know, finesse that one brings in work. In the long run, you will not benefit with shortcuts. However, the competition in weddings is far lesser compared to what you will experience in corporate events, because weddings requires a certain kind of temperament. It requires a certain level of expertise which is beyond the regular. It is high pressure. You are going to need to be temperamentally strong if you're running your own wedding management company. You also need to be able to motivate your team to spend endless hours, days, weeks of, you know, no gratitude work that comes your way. And you are going to be involved in a project for a much longer time. While a corporate event may just require a couple of weeks of involvement, because the programs, especially the incentive programs, are largely designed by the multinational company themselves. But the program designing, the function designing, belongs to a wedding planner. So our job requires us to be involved for nearly a year. So there's a lot of time consumption that goes into it. So that becomes your one major differentiating factor. Are you a kind of person who likes to move from one project to the other? Are you a person who has the patience to deal with the family and their emotions and their demands for 9 months, 6 months to a year? That's the way you can actually decide. Oh, Rituraj sir is saying next class should be on copycats. So I'm going to take this damn seriously, and I would love for you and me to do this session together. It's going to be kick-ass, if I'm allowed to use that word. I don't know if the wedding school will permit me, but you know what I'm saying, because I cannot imagine how much of that you are facing. And yes, guys, please, everyone entering the industry, for your own sake, for your own conscience, please do have some level of integrity. You get inspired from someone, great, but I think a bit of credit needs to be shared. You just cannot, you know, claim work that you haven't even done. Hemant is agreeing with you, sir. So is Tejas Vyas, I think, sir. It is crazy. I think one of the virtues, you know, that we do teach at TWS, and trust me, I'm not plugging this in, but I can feel your pain. And I have gone through it a lot of times when there are a couple entries that I have designed, and there are clients who then end up showing me that work, you know, and asking me, aap ye kar sakte, and I'm just wondering, I'm like, ye mera hi kaam tha. So there are these things that happen. There are costumes that we make for outfit, you know, events, and then it's all over the place. So it happens, sir. And yes, let's do a session on this, the next one. I hope my team has queued that in already. My last point that differentiates for me is the kind of professional learning that is required. And the learning that you get at an event management institute, like I had said a little earlier, will actually have its focus, you know, and it will give you a fair idea, but it will only give you that much knowledge, because it is more generic. The approach is that let's get the student updated in terms of the different streams of work, whether it's sports management, corporate events, special events, you know, awards or weddings. Whereas if you study with a wedding management school, your entire focus and every session is about getting you ready in terms of how to prepare presentations, how to meet a wedding client, how do you actually work in tandem with a decor and design house, how do you plan a menu. So everything is very specific to from the wedding perspective. There's no generic knowledge that is given. And therefore, you can become a far more bigger contributor to an industry rather than be a person with generic knowledge and then you get hired by an agency and then you sit to learn. I don't think that's fair. It's only nice, and the demand for people with a know-how is just getting bigger and bigger and greater and greater. So that's what it is. So whether it is to do with competition, whether it's to do with difficulty, whether it's to do with your career prospects, whether it's to do with emotions versus professional, professionalism and the technical know-how. I think I've covered by far everything that differentiates corporate events and event management from wedding management. And I really hope that I have been able to help you understand the difference. And therefore, for those of you who are still in a dilemma, hopefully you've got some kind of clarity and you will be able to take that decision. If not, please feel free to speak to our counselors at the wedding school. We're based out of Mumbai, but we do help you out pan India. We do have a lot of students, in fact, coming in from different parts of the country. Rituraj is saying, perfect timing. I read Jaipur, Fairmont to attend EMF. Ping me when you have your next session. I am definitely doing that, sir. And have a great time at EMF. And I am sure that your fans in the form of, you know, decor houses and florists and planners and artists, they're eagerly waiting for your attention at EMF. A wonderful initiative bringing the wedding fraternity together. I tell you guys, this is really the next big thing. And everyone who's in a dilemma, do not think so much. Just go with your passion, be ready for hard work, and do not copy. I hope, Rituraj, sir, I've conveyed your message. Daniel says, thank you lot for the information, ma'am. Thank you, Daniel. It's totally my pleasure. I am very passionate about weddings. I'm very passionate to ensure that in years to come, there are more professional, knowledgeable people. There are more people who can call themselves contributors. And I'm very, very focused on being one of the many creators of these contributors. So on behalf of the wedding school, this is Marisha signing off. And do remember our hashtag, mazak hai kya? Bilkul mazak nahi hai. Take it seriously, get yourself educated and be a contributor and have a fantastic life filled with highs and lows and dramas and excitement and of course, lots of money. See you guys. See you soon. Goodbye, everybody, and have a great weekend.